views expressed on this program are those of the hosts, guests, and callers, and are not necessarily those of the station, its management, or other advertisers. You're listening to Transformation Talk Radio.
Ballard Show. Insight and inspiration from the great beyond. Kelly Ballard is a fourth generation medium and intuitive who covers topics ranging from grief, spirit guides, and listening to your intuition. Kelly can help you get answers and guidance from your loved ones on the other side with a little bit of humor and a lot of healing. Now, here's your host, Kelly Ballard.
Well, good afternoon. Hello, everyone. I'm Kelly Ballard. And you're listening to The Kelly Ballard Show, Insight and Inspiration from the Great Beyond on Transformation Talk Radio. I'm so glad that you joined me today. It is a very gloomy fall day in upstate New York, and I'm hoping that wherever you are tuning in from, maybe you have some sunshine, or at least you are warm and happy and in a great, great place. Thank you so much for sharing your brilliant energy with me today. We're going to do some awesome things together with Spirit, and I'm glad you're on this journey with me. Stay with me for the next hour as we open up our hearts and our minds to connect in with Spirit and educate ourselves with divine energy. Each week, we cover a variety of topics ranging from grief and spirit guides, mediumship, listening to your intuition, and so much more. And if you're wondering how you can find me outside of Transformation Talk Radio, you can always check out my website, reflectiveharmony.com, for more information on how to schedule a private reading with me, whether that's in person in my Clifton Park, New York office, or over the phone. I read for clients all over the United States and internationally. And you can also read about some of my upcoming classes and webinars, and just to kind of stay in the loop with what I've got going on. So you can check out my website at reflectiveharmony.com. So speaking of classes, I've been keeping you guys posted on some webinars that I started, and I'm excited about these because it's giving me a chance to reach out to my wonderful, wonderful clients and listeners like you who are all over the U.S. and able to connect in with you and to work with you out of the comfort of your own home. So we've got four that are coming up, and I'm excited. So December 9th is working with your spirit guides webinar. January 13th, working with your gut instincts. February 3rd, connecting in with our past lives. And February 24th, automatic writing and divine guidance. And all of these webinars, you can sign up for them on my website, reflectiveharmony.com. They all start at 7 p.m. Eastern. And we are going to have fun, and just open up your mind to see what you can do with spirit. You don't need to have any prior mediumistic, intuitive, psychic, healing, you name it, any metaphysical experience. I do all the heavy lifting, and my job is to help crack that door open for you to reconnect with your source, reconnect with that awesome, awesome energy that's all around us. So, can you believe that we are like halfway into November? I don't know where October went, and I don't know where November is going. And I feel like before we know it, Thanksgiving is going to be here and then into Christmas. But, you know, one of the things that I love about this time of year specifically, and I think the fall in general always just gets me into a place of gratitude. And, you know, I know if you're somebody who's on Facebook, you'll see a lot that there's, you know, people start their gratitude challenges and they start listing, you know, what they're grateful for. Gratitude for me is something that I try to be mindful of, well, most of the time, multiple times a day. But I always make an intention every day to really go through and to look at the things I'm grateful for. And whether they're little things, like maybe I got a green light because I was in a hurry, although I suppose that could be a big thing if I was in a hurry. Or maybe it's somebody who, you know, took the time to listen to me or made me laugh or warmed up my heart. There are so many things in life that we can be thankful for. And this is always a time of year to look into that and to remember that. So I'm not saying you've got to go post it all over Facebook and whatnot, but maybe take a few minutes between now and Thanksgiving and just find within yourself, what are you grateful for? What makes you happy? What brought you joy? Who brought you joy? The little things, the big things, and everything in between. When we become more mindful of gratitude, we actually connect in so much more abundance, so much more prosperity, so much more good in our life because we're emitting an energy of gratitude. So it's so important to be mindful of that. And there's my little gratitude plug for today. So speaking of today, we have an awesome show, and I've been really looking forward to this for a couple weeks now. We're going to be talking all about Archangels and Ascended Masters, one of my favorite topics. And I got to tell you, my office has been filling up with high vibration energy all day today. I've had a couple Archangels come in. I've got a bunch of Ascended Masters here. And I know it's just going to keep filling up with more and more when we start talking about them and really drawing in on that energy from today's show. If you are following along on Facebook, my intuitive students, my mediumistic students in my class that I teach on Thursday nights, they are going to be in for a great treat tonight with all this beautiful energy running through my office suite. So we're having a lot of fun here. So with Ascended Masters and Archangels, we're going to find out, who is this team of people on the other side? How do they want to help us? We're going to break down what they do and really just kind of the nuts and bolts of this whole other vibration of beings that are with you and available to help. And I'm excited because I'm going to be taking callers, and that's where you grab the pen and paper, and you can call in at 800-930-2819. That's 800-930-2819. And I'm going to be taking callers throughout the show to connect you in. Who's working with you? What Archangel, what Ascended Master is working with you and here to help, so that we're going to have a lot of fun. So get comfy. Stay with me for the next hour. We are going to tune into some great, great things. And I'm hoping that we'll be able to open your minds and your heart a bit about this fascinating topic. So I'm glad you're with me today. And again, that number, if you want to jot it down, is 800-930-2819. So 800-930-2819. And if you're interested in following along with today's show, you can check out more on my Facebook page, facebook.com/reflectiveharmonykmb, and also my website, reflectiveharmony.com. We'll have an archive of today's show listed there tomorrow that you can check out as well. So let's get into this. Let's talk about these awesome beings. So we have all sorts of people on the other side that work with us. So we've talked about our spirit guides. We've talked about our loved ones, even our furry four-legged friends. We have, angel energy, but we also have two other groups of beings of energy that really can, I like to call, like, these are the big guns. Like, these are the energy, the vibrations that when you need something to happen, when you need something to get done, these are the people that you call upon to make that happen. And we're going to break down, how do they help us? What do they do? And we're going to be getting into, ways to kind of find out, basically, how can you utilize these great people on a day-to-day basis to enhance your life, to enhance healing, love, you name it, that we can utilize these. So let's talk about Ascended Masters first. So an Ascended Master is a being who has become self-realized and serves humanity. This is a being that has raised his or her vibration to a sustained frequency of light, of energy, that he or she can come and go at will from our earth plane, where you and I are, without that birth-death cycle. A lot of people do believe that Ascended Masters were individuals that were living on our human plane at one point as well, and that they came into this world to do things to really to serve as like teachers, to open up our eyes, to make us think a little bit, to make us have a giant aha moment. And, now that they're on the other side, they come back in and forth, and we can utilize them to serve us. Ascended Masters, they are are these enlightened spiritual beings who, you know, faced the same challenges that you and I faced, probably ones that are worse. And, you know, they've been reunited with their source, with their creator. And today they serve as teachers of mankind. So think of it from these teachers that can guide us, protect, inspire us, that can heal us. They are teachers in the truest sense of the word, and they can help us grow in any area of our lives and achieve the real purpose of life. And at the end of the day, that's to become one with source, one with this bigger vibration than all of us. One of the things that I like about with Ascended Masters in particular here is, you know, if you're somebody who, you know, admires people. So you could look at someone like Mother Teresa. You could look at somebody like Abraham Lincoln, for example. There are people who believe that these individuals have evolved on into the other side and, you know, have completed the work they were supposed to do here to open minds, to open our hearts, and, you know, are now working with us. So some commonly heard Ascended Masters are as follows, and these might have you raising some eyebrows, but I'm going to ask you to bear with me and to open up your mind and just to mull on this a little bit. So people, Kuan Yin, Saint Germain, Krishna, John the Baptist, Padre Pio, Lakshmi, Ganesh, Buddha, Mary, Jesus, these are just some of a few of the Ascended Masters that people believe that we have access to and that we are able to connect in with and, you know, to utilize to help us to grow and to be this great being. If you are just tuning in, you're listening to the Kelly Ballard Show, Insight and Inspiration from the Great Beyond on Transformation Talk Radio. We've got to take a quick break, but when we come back, we're going to be getting more into the topic of Ascended Masters and Archangels and see what we can get cooking. Stay tuned. We'll be right back.
The legend lives on from the Chippewa on down at the big lake they call Gitche-Gumee. The lake, it is said, never gives up her dead when the skies of November turn.
Enlightening, humorous, and compassionate. Listen live to The Kelly Ballard Show, Insight and Inspiration from the Great Beyond. Kelly is a fourth-generation medium and intuitive who covers topics ranging from grief, spirit guides, and listening to your intuition. Kelly can help you get answers and guidance from the other side with a little bit of humor and a lot of healing. Tune in to The Kelly Ballard Show Thursdays at 1 p.m. Pacific Time here on TransformationTalkRadio.com.
Holistic Medical Center is where you find it all. A healthy space with doctors who care, see, and listen to the whole you. Hi, this is Dr. Darvish. If you have not found an answer to your chronic symptoms, you will find answers here at Holistic Medical Center. Our doctors find the root cause of your symptoms and guide your body towards healing naturally. We transform lives from within. Visit drdarvish.com or call 425-451-0404.
Are you seeking a more deeply connected and fulfilling life? Do you often find yourself feeling overwhelmed, overworked, or exhausted? Are you ready to embrace a life filled with more love, connection, and joy? Best of the Month list and 5-star rated on Amazon, Conscious Being by author TJ Woodward will awaken you to your true nature. To learn more about how to get your copy of Conscious Being, visit ConsciousBeingBook.com today.
Let the transition begin. Tune in to the hit show, Majestic Insights Radio, Success for Life's Transitions, with host Carrie Keith. Carrie is a gifted intuitive coach, healer, and teacher who will lead you through her empowering techniques of ancient wisdom and awareness so you can live your happiest, healthiest, and most vibrant life. Let Carrie teach you the tools of transformation that will help you experience success for all of life's transitions. To learn more about Carrie, visit www.majesticinsights.com.
How would you like increased health and vitality? How would you like to avoid the onset of disease as well as slow the aging process? This is all possible through a simple, safe, and natural process. Every day, we are either moving toward wellness or away from wellness.
Hi, I'm Mary Jane Mack. I'd like to be your partner in achieving optimal health. Contact me now at MaryJaneMack.com or call 425-392-0659. Visit MaryJaneMack.com.
1230 WBLQ.
We've already said
welcome back. You're listening to the Kelly Ballard Show, Insight and Inspiration from the Great Beyond with me, Kelly Ballard, on Transformation Talk Radio. Thanks for joining me today. And if you're just tuning in and you have a moment, be sure to check out my latest posting on my Facebook page about today's show. And we'll have an archive up of the show on my website, reflectiveharmony.com, after today's show as well. We have been just starting to talk about Ascended Masters, and we'll be getting into Archangels in just a moment. And I want to remind you to give me a call at 800-930-2819. That's 800-930-2819. I would love to tune into your energy and let you know which Ascended Master or Archangel is working with you today. So give me a call. We're gonna do some awesome stuff together. So we were just talking about Archangels and, Ascended Masters, we were talking about them, and that these are very enlightened spiritual beings who have lived on Earth, who have lived on our plane, face the same challenges that we face today, and then have now, you know, obviously reunited with a creator of their own understanding. They serve us as teachers of mankind. They guide, protect, inspire us, and are really teachers in the truest sense of the word. And we were mentioning, that some commonly heard Ascended Masters, we were talking about Jesus, Mary, Buddha, Ganesh, Padre Pio, Krishna, Saint Germain, Kuan Yin. There are a whole slew of them. And if you are somebody that you like books and you like to check out some more information, I can recommend to you, Doreen Virtue is sort of like the angel guru, and she writes a wonderful, wonderful book called Archangels and Ascended Masters, and it's a guide to working and healing with divinities and deities. And it's a fantastic resource that I often use with my students and with clients that can help you really figure out who's working with you, who's around you, and how they're utilizing your energy as well. So I actually want to go to the phone and take a caller for a moment here, and we'll see what's cooking. We've got Lisa calling from Norfolk, Virginia. Hi, Lisa. How are you?
Hi. How are you, Kelly?
I'm good. So, Lisa, can I connect in with an Ascended Master or an Archangel for you?
I would love that.
Do you have a preference which one you'd like me to try to get?
No. Whoever pops in.
All right. I'm going to go with an Ascended Master. I was being drawn with that energy because we've been talking about it, and we're going to start from there in that sense. So bear with me just one moment, Lisa. Let me see who we've got touching in with you and who wants to give you some assistance and a little bit of help in that sense. All right. Great. Here. Ooh, this is very interesting. Okay, so Lisa, touching in with your energy, I have Isis, and her name is spelled I-S-I-S, who is touching in with you, an Ascended Master. So I'm going to give you a little bit of homework to go and do, because, of course, with all of this, there's so much that you can also tune into and read online about all of these wonderful, wonderful beings in that sense. But one of the things that I really like in particular about Isis's energy is there's a sense of not only the feminine, but also really a feeling of kind of looking at a sense of balance and looking at a sense of peace. And I feel very strongly that with your connection, that this is about keeping balance in your life. It's about helping you to look at a part of you that might feel, she comes in with an energy to help you looking at a part of your life that maybe feels lopsided. You might feel burnt out, a sense of imbalance, and to help you to kind of shift that energy and move it around, to reorganize priorities, to reorganize, I feel like I could use her right now. Oh my gosh. To, you know, look at a part of you to find a way to kind of live the best life that, that you can in that sense. Oftentimes she shows up when, to make sure that our needs are being met, to help us to delegate things, to say no to unrealistic demands on our time, and to help us to be honest and to keep, good boundaries within ourselves, with that like balance between like work and home life and everything as well. So you have an amazing, amazing, and Isis is Egyptian, just so you know that, as she's a goddess. She also symbolizes feminine strength and power. So you have a little homework. You can go and Google a whole bunch more about her. You can look her up in one of Doreen Virtue's books. You can even check her out on Doreen Virtue makes a fantastic deck of Archangel, Ascended Master Oracle cards. And you can also check out some stuff with that as well. But you've got a fantastic, fantastic being working with you, Lisa. And I wish you all the best.
Perfect. Thank you so much. That's exciting.
Have a great day.
Thank you. You too.
So as I was just mentioning actually to Lisa, there's also, if you are somebody that likes Doreen Virtue, she puts out a lot of different like oracle decks with cards. And there's two that when I do these exercises with my students for Ascended Masters and Archangels, I often will pull out these decks. And what they have great, great visual images, so you can really get an idea of the energy that's working with you. But one of the things that I like to do is, specifically with my Archangel deck, is I like to just pull out a random card, see what's coming to me, and try to work with that energy all week long. So if you are someone that's trying to push and grow from a spiritual perspective where your development is concerned, you might want to consider taking a little bit of a path like that and taking a little bit of a route from that perspective and seeing what you can, who you can pick up and what kind of a connection that you can develop. So let's also get into Archangels. So Archangels, I love these guys. Archangels, they are all of their names end in the EL suffix, and the EL meaning in God. So the first half of their name means what each individual angel specializes in, and then obviously the second half, the EL meaning in God. Archangels can be in many, many places at one time. You never have to feel like your problem, your issue isn't important enough to bother them with. I and I'll tell you a little story in a moment about how I use one of them specifically. So whatever you want to use them for, they are there, and you, and it's what we call invoking their energy into our vibration. They are here to help you to heal, to learn, to grow. My favorite, and of course, I think he's kind of the big gun of all the archangels, is Archangel Michael. And he means he who is like God. And one of the things that I visualize with Archangel Michael when I invoke his energy, and it's something simply as just saying, Archangel Michael, I invoke your energy now, he brings through heat. So one of the things that people will talk about that they notice is that when you are calling in that energy, when you're bringing that vibration into you, one of the things that people will feel is like the sweat's kind of coming on. And I'm not talking about like a hot sweat, but meaning like you might notice all of a sudden your cheeks get really flushed and warm. Your hands get really, really warm. You might notice a little bit of like perspiration on your forehead. He comes in with heat. And the Archangel Michael, he is an archangel that can be as tall as, I don't like to fly. And so I always invoke his energy when I fly. And what I do is I literally envision him taking the airplane in the palm of his hand and walking us to our destination. So he can be that big, or he also can be teeny tiny, to sit on your shoulder. He is a great, kind of like a catch-all of archangels. I oftentimes, I'll send him to school with my kids to watch over them. If I maybe am doing some work, maybe some criminal work, with a client or something, you know, that's a little bit more sensitive in nature, that I'm tuning into, I'll ask his energy to come in, not only to protect my energy, but raise my vibration as well. So he is my go-to guy and somebody that I work with multiple times a day. You can't be a broken record to him. That's important to know as well. He can be in many places at once. We can all be utilizing him. And he's got a great, great energy, and someone that I very much enjoy invoking. Another archangel that is very helpful to use as well is Raphael. And Raphael means healing power of God. The divine has healed. And what's interesting is he is sort of the archangel that if you are dealing with any emotional, physical, anything that you need healing for, that you've got problems, issues, some stress right now, he is going to be your go-to angel. He is going to be the one that can give you that support, that boost, all of that energy to help kind of open you up, lift you up to whatever that you're going to be needing in that sense. So he's a great person, Raphael, to call upon when you're needing healing done on you. It's interesting to me because I have some students that are very, very drawn to Raphael and have gone through their own crises and their own problems, and he's really come through for them from a healing standpoint. And I do know a couple of people who've had what we call miraculous healing from invoking his energy as well. So shoot big always. We also have Archangel Gabriel, which is probably someone you've heard of as well, meaning strength of God. The divine is my strength. And Gabriel is a very, very interesting angel as well, because I sort of look at him as being the one that can kind of carry the heavy stuff, the burdens that might feel overwhelming, strong. I look at him sort of as like the rock in that sense. So he's somebody that if you're having a tough time and just needing some extra TLC, that's a great person to invoke him. And a couple other ones that you may have heard, Archangel Uriel, meaning God is light, God's light, fire of God. Ariel, Lion of God, is often associated with like courage. Let's see here, Metatron. Let me tell you something neat real quick about Metatron and Sandalphon. Metatron and Sandalphon are two of the only archangels who do not end in EL, and they were also the only archangels who were human before becoming angels as well. So Metatron does work with just an angelic presence that comes in. Sandalphon comes in also as allowing people to work as far as continuing sacred service. So if you are a healer or somebody who likes to work with spirit and in that realm, those are also angels who come in and enjoy doing that work as well. So if you are just tuning in, you're listening to the Kelly Ballard Show, Insight and Inspiration from the Great Beyond on Transformation Talk Radio. When we come back, those phone lines are open. Call in 800-930-2819. I would love to connect you in with an archangel or an ascended master. Stay tuned. We'll be right back.
Planet Radio with Dr. Kelly Neff. This hit show will illuminate your senses and empower you beyond your daily stressors and hardships. Renowned psychologist and author Dr. Kelly will captivate you with far-reaching topics and amazing guests as you wake to the greatest version of yourself. Learn to tap into your intuitions, think critically about our world, heal emotional and psychological wounds, and follow your passions to live your dreams. The Lucid Planet, welcome home. Visit lucidplanetradio.com for more information.
My dream is to end homelessness.
My passion is living a green life.
My dream is to end poverty.
My passion is volunteering.
My passion is making a difference.
My dream is to cure Lyme disease.
My passion is rebuilding communities.
My passion is helping those in need.
My passion is caring for the elderly.
My dream is to find a cure for cancer.
My dream is to leave a better world for my children.
We all have that special passion, that lifelong dream that drives us to live our lives with meaning and to create a better world. No matter what drives you, we can all make an impact. Dr. Pat Basile is helping others make their dreams come true, so we can all help make our world a better world.
To learn more about how Dr. Pat is building a community of sharing hope, strength, funds, knowledge, and information, visit abetterworldcrowdfunding.com today. That's abetterworldcrowdfunding.com.
enlightening, humorous, and compassionate. Listen live to The Kelly Ballard Show, insight and inspiration from the great beyond. Kelly is a fourth-generation medium and intuitive who covers topics ranging from grief, spirit guides, and listening to your intuition. Kelly can help you get answers and guidance from the other side with a little bit of humor and a lot of healing. Tune in to The Kelly Ballard Show Thursdays at 1 p.m. Pacific Time here on TransformationTalkRadio.com.
Transformation Talk Radio is dedicated to the education and awareness of Lyme disease.
Hey, everybody. Welcome back to Lyme Talk Radio. I'm Dr. Pat, joined here by
Dr. Nusheen Darvish.
Dr. Pat Basile and Dr. Nusheen Darvish will be bringing the most innovative, groundbreaking information, research, treatment innovations, and stories from those it affects every day.
I'm so excited to be talking about this.
We have so much to share.
Dr. Darvish and I are planning to do is connect the dots.
People suffering with all sorts of chronic diseases, it's time. It is time for them to transform.
Tune into Lyme Talk Radio and help keep our mission strong.
For the loyal listeners out there that have been listening to this incredible show on Lyme disease, we are not going to let you down. We're going to come through stronger and enrich the platform for Lyme disease awareness through Lyme Talk Radio. The message will continue. The conversations will become stronger and the healing epic.
1230 WBLQ.
Back on the Kelly Ballard Show, insight and inspiration from the great beyond with me, Kelly Ballard, on Transformation Talk Radio. Don't forget to check out my Facebook page for some tidbits from today's show. I was mentioning a couple books and some oracle card decks that revolve around the Archangels and Ascended Masters. You can find a photo of those up on Facebook if you want to order them. And you can always also check out my website, reflectiveharmony.com, for an archive of today's show and also my recent appearances on the Dr. Pat Show. So we've got some callers lined up and I'm excited to get to them. And let me give you that number again if you want to call in and find out which Archangel or Ascended Master is working with you. You can reach me at 800-930-2819. That's 800-930-2819. So I'd love to go to Isabella from Albany, New York. Hi, Isabella. How are you?
Good. How are you?
Good. Isabella, can I connect in with an Archangel or an Ascended Master for you?
Yes, you can.
And do you have a preference which one?
Michael the Archangel.
Not a problem. Bear with me. Let's get his energy in here. So, Isabella, as I mentioned to you, one of the great things about the Archangel Michael is he is one of those beings that the moment that you ask for him, that you invoke his energy or just ask to speak to him in general, he is there and he is with you and supporting you greatly in that sense. So just by asking him today, asking me to check in with him and tune into him for you, he is very, very present there. He is, as I mentioned, kind of my go-to guy, and I see him as being somebody for you that I want to call like an inspiration. He is somebody that I feel right now is coming in to kind of not only lift you in that sense, but I feel like he's trying to kind of pull away a lot of fear, a lot of worry. He's giving me kind of this sense that there's like a very weighty, a lot of weighty emotional stuff that's sitting on you right now. So he definitely comes in. Oh, that's interesting. Thank you. He comes in and trying to clear that away. Now, one of the things with the Archangel Michael, he's very tall and very handsome. Think like a very handsome gladiator. And one of the things that you always will see him with is a sword and a shield. And it was interesting because when I said to you that he was coming in to kind of try to like cut through and move away some of that energy, the visual that he gave me literally was just taking that sword and just cutting through this mass of just worry and pain and emotional stuff that has been sitting with you for quite some time. So I feel his presence very, very loving and supportive, trying to help you to you know, not feel stuck and not to feel like this sense of like lost. He's trying to help you to kind of put stuff into action, this kind of go, go, go energy in that sense. He helps people with communication, with dedication to what someone is believing in or feeling passionate about. He helps with courage and direction, energy, vitality, life's purpose, motivation, protection, clearing the energy of your space, and also worthiness and increased self-esteem. So anytime that you can invoke him. You could do something simply as simple. There we go. You could do something as simple as Archangel Michael, I invoke your energy now, and he is there supporting you, loving you, and helping you for whatever you need. And you can't over invoke him. So whatever you need him for, consider him there and present with you. Okay.
Okay.
Thank
All
you.
Right. Thank
Take
you.
Take care. And I'd like to go to the phone and to another caller, actually. We have Emily calling from Saratoga, New York. Hi, Emily. How are you?
I'm good. How are you?
I'm good. Emily, can I connect in with an archangel or an ascended master for you?
I actually really just have a general question for spirit.
Sure.
Okay?
Sure.
So I've been looking for a job in my field and just trying to figure out my journey, and I was wondering if Spirit had anything for me.
Sure, just a moment. Emily, as I'm tuning into your energy, one of the things that I'm getting very loudly here is I'm seeing with you that this is about kind of going back to what I want to say is like the source, going back to kind of what your heart is looking for and what you're interested in. I feel like that we all go through periods in our life where we kind of get a, I don't want to say like a big idea, but we think that we have to go and to take a journey with something elaborate and something huge and really to kind of find this place to like slam our foot down, stake our claim to say, okay, I'm conquering this. And what I keep hearing with you is keep it simple, keep it simple. You have an opportunity that they're showing me is literally like right in front of you, right under your nose, and to not necessarily think on the bigger perspective, but to look at something that is a little bit like closer to you, that a little is literally right underneath you in that sense. And it's interesting because there still is a part of, oh, that's helpful. Thank you. They're telling me, that you have a your message of what you're asking them for is in two separate places. Now, you have a woman coming through in your mom's side of the family, and I feel a grandmother energy. I don't get a sense that she would have met you in physical form, but has been watching over you as a spirit for a very, very long time. So she kind of laughs at me and says, oh, she's in the know, like she knows all about you in that sense. And one of the things, Emily, that she's showing me here is that she's saying that what you're kind of putting out is conflicting information. So I feel like there's a part of you that still has this desire within your heart to kind of make like this major, major, huge splash in that sense. And I think that that's something that you can still do, but in a very subtle way. So I don't know if there was a part of you that is looking at like either like a major relocation or it's big, that part of your mind is. And she's saying, no, stay right here. Like it's right under your nose. It's right in front of you in that sense. I will tell you, this month of November feels very fruitful. It feels very hot to me. It gives me very much of an energy like, ooh, you are onto something here. So I do feel very strongly that this is going to be something that will come to fruition for you, that you're going to start to get a lead, start to get kind of a leg forward within this month. But again, I'm just hearing strongly to make sure that what you're wanting is consistent. So kind of like don't split your wants, to kind of keep focused on exactly what you want and kind of let go of another idea in that sense. Okay.
All right. Thank you.
Best of luck with everything. Take care.
Thank you.
You're welcome. So as we were chatting about archangels and ascended masters, I was talking to you a little bit about, earlier with kind of my practice that I like to do with like the oracle cards. So this week I've been actually focusing a whole bunch of energy on Gabriel. And it's been interesting because I look at things within my life in particular of, and Gabriel, by the way, if you're just tuning in, is strength of God. The divine is in my strength as an archangel. So he comes through as somebody that is sort of like that rock in that sense. And it's interesting to me because whenever I pull a card of an archangel or an ascended master, and I'm thinking, well, geez, why do I have this person coming in? Or, you know, what does this mean? Or what does that mean? And, you know, you start looking at the energy, and it's interesting because just making that connection, even if you don't understand why per se, you might be having somebody showing up and somebody helping, it's fascinating to me because I feel like it gives you a real opportunity. It gives you a chance to not only learn about the areas in your life that maybe are feeling a little bit more vulnerable or maybe feeling a little bit more stagnant, but sometimes areas in our life that we don't even realize sometimes have us feeling in a funk or have us feeling a little out of sorts. We have a chance to clear out that energy, to move good stuff in, and just to be really truly supported and loved by this being that is so much bigger than all of us and just can help us in ways that we may not always understand. So, it's a fun little thing that I like to do, and I think it helps to enhance my connection with Source. I think it helps to enhance a lot of the work that I do with my clients of just who else is out there and available for assistance when we need someone as well. So something to think about if you are wanting also to kind of expand that awareness and that practice of who is around you and what they're doing for that matter as well. So as I mentioned earlier in the show, our phone lines are open. You can call in at 800-930-2819. I would love to let you know who's working with you as far as an archangel is concerned or an ascended master. Find out what they're doing, how they're helping, and ways that you get to work with them and invoke that beautiful, beautiful energy coming in. There are just a tremendous, tremendous amount of, there's about a dozen archangels that we work with, but with ascended masters, there is just a truckload of them. And, you know, one of the great things is that I think that I really like about Doreen Virtue's book with them is that there's a listing in there that whatever your issue is or whatever you're needing some help with. So for example, if you were having some issues, if you are a writer and you are having a writing block and you're a little bit stuck, you can look up in this book and say, oh, you know what? Archangel Gabriel, Athena, and Ganesh, three people that all help with with making that block go away and to opening you up. So it's a great, great resource to connect in with. We need to take a quick break. If you're interested in connecting in with me, you can always check out my website, reflectiveharmony.com. Give us a call. I'd love to tune in to one of your archangels or ascended masters. We'll be right back.
You should have seen by the look in my eyes, baby, there was something missing. You should have known by the tone of my voice, maybe, but you didn't listen. You played dead, but you never bled. Instead,
hi, I'm Tim Darter.
And I'm Steve Kramer.
Join us on Spirit Fire Radio. Discover how to add the mechanics of meditation to your day.
And watch yourself connect in a whole new way. Find the amazing moments in life's routines that often pass us by. Add to your awareness with Spirit Fire Radio.
Tune in each Wednesday at 9 a.m. for your weekly guide to practical mindfulness. And to learn more, visit www.spiritfireradio.com.
Enlightening, humorous, and compassionate. Listen live to The Kelly Ballard Show, insight and inspiration from the great beyond. Kelly is a fourth-generation medium and intuitive who covers topics ranging from grief, spirit guides, and listening to your intuition. Kelly can help you get answers and guidance from the other side with a little bit of humor and a lot of healing. Tune in to The Kelly Ballard Show, Thursdays at 1 p.m. Pacific Time here on TransformationTalkRadio.com.
Tune in to The Truth Is Funny with Colette Stephan each Wednesday at 8 a.m. Pacific, 11 a.m. Eastern on TransformationTalkRadio.com. This hit show will have you thinking outside the box and riding the wave of infinite potential. Join Colette on the Higher Self Network, inspiring listeners to shine their brilliance and ensure success while roaring with laughter as they recognize the humor of the giant cosmic joke. Visit TheTruthIsFunny.com.
Enlightening, humorous, and compassionate. Listen live to The Kelly Ballard Show, insight and inspiration from the great beyond. Kelly is a fourth-generation medium and intuitive who covers topics ranging from grief, spirit guides, and listening to your intuition. Kelly can help you get answers and guidance from the other side with a little bit of humor and a lot of healing. Tune in to The Kelly Ballard Show, Thursdays at 1 p.m. Pacific Time here on TransformationTalkRadio.com.
To Sheer Alchemy with Leslie Fontaine on TransformationTalkRadio.com and get ready to stir up your passions, remove your blocks, and shift into an entirely new existence. Speaker, teacher, channel, clairvoyant, Leslie Fontaine is a transformation catalyst who channels a powerful energy from Source to catapult listeners into living the life they were born to live. Whether it's shifting from scarcity to abundance, from emotional pain into joy, or from illness into health, Leslie will help you step into the true essence and power of all that you are with the help of the Ascended Masters and Archangels. You will not be the same. Visit TransformationTalkRadio.com for show dates and times and LeslieFontaine.com to say yes to explosive abundance.
1230 WBLQ.
Have I a hope or half a chance to even ask if I could dance with you?
We're back on the Kelly Ballard Show, insight and inspiration from the great beyond with me, Kelly Ballard. I so appreciate you spending time with me today. And as a medium and intuitive consultant, I work with spirit daily to provide my clients with answers, insight, and inspiration from their loved ones on the other side. We have some time left for callers. So if you do want to check in to see which archangel or ascended master is working with you, give me a call. And that number is 800-930-2819. 800-930-2819, and I would love an opportunity to connect you in with one of these amazing beings. And as always, if you would like to contact me for more information about my services or to book an appointment for a reading, whether that's in person in my Clifton Park, New York office or over the phone, you can go to my website, reflectiveharmony.com. All the information is on there to read about how I work, what I do, and everything in between. So I would love to connect actually, and we've got a caller and I'd love to connect in with her. So let's go to Connie from New York. Hi, Connie. How are you?
Hi, Kelly. I'm well. Thank you. How are you?
Good. Connie, can I connect you in with an ascended master or an archangel?
Yes, I would love to see if anybody is hanging around or wants to get in touch with me.
And do you have a preference?
Well, I am familiar with Michael and Raphael, but I was actually curious to see if there was any other master archangel out there that is hanging around and would be great for, like, strength and support.
Well, let me tell you, I don't know if this is maybe what you want, but I will tell you this. The first one that just popped in when you started talking is what we're going to go with. So I'm going to have you indulge me and spirit here. So Connie, I'm excited because this is one of my favorite ascended masters, Lakshmi, who is the Hindu goddess of abundance and prosperity. And I love her energy because she is one of those beings that just comes through with you need it, you any area in your life where you want something enhanced, that you want something to be more abundant, to be more prosperous, she is your go-to gal in that sense. And what I keep hearing from her today is that this is an indication about prayers for abundance and growth being answered to you, I'm hearing. I'm feeling that this is also something for you about needing to realize that you are so much better of a manifester than you realize that you are. And I keep hearing this from her of saying, you know, you are in growth mode right now, she's saying, and there is so much that is open to you, Connie, and there's so much that is going to be expanding and blossoming and exploding for that matter as well. And she's saying that you have nothing to fear, but to also accept and to trust that a new flow of this abundance, of this prosperity is going to be coming into you very, very easily. Oftentimes, the meaning with her is reassurance of everything being okay in respect to finances, professional growth, any support that you need to make a desired life change, anything that you need with strength right now to visualize and affirm her being able to do that in that sense. She is all about goals and she's all about manifesting, and she is just this beautiful, beautiful goddess. And, you know, one of the things with her is that I think that she comes through with wanting people to be happy, wanting to see them thrive and to create lasting happiness. And not that wealth creates our happiness in that sense, but I'm a very big believer that abundance and prosperity comes in all shapes and sizes. And I see her as being someone that is trying to give you that reassurance. She is also associated with the lotus flower. So you might notice that if you start seeing lotuses around, that's also an indication that she could be working with you. And she's also somebody that I feel like is good for any sort of a challenge that you want to, and I kind of mentioned this to you earlier, any sort of a challenge that you have. So we could look at that as strength. She is somebody also who helps people to meet their goals and to kind of live up to where they need to in that sense. She also helps with abundance, beauty, and aesthetics, because who doesn't need to look nice every day? Happiness, and also manifesting anything for home and family. And she's great for clearing out any yucky energy in the home that you don't need. And again, invoking her energy is just, whether it's a visual, you can go into Google and actually find some really, really beautiful images of her in that sense. You could make her a screensaver on your computer if you wanted to, or on your phone. And just, you know, anything that you want to do to invoke her energy is just connecting in with her and saying, you know, I invoke your energy now, Lakshmi. And of course, with all the abundance that she brings, don't forget to say thank you as well.
Oh, wonderful. Thanks. I'm so glad I called in. Thank you, Kelly. I appreciate you taking my call.
Hey, it's my pleasure, and much abundance and prosperity to you.
Wonderful. Thank you.
You're welcome. I just absolutely love being able to connect people in with these beings, because really it's one of these situations that if you can allow yourself to really take a moment and to really understand who else is around you and who's there and what they are giving to you, it is completely, completely limitless about what you can bring in and what can change within your life. And, you know, I think that when I first got interested in Archangels and Ascended Masters, and I thought to myself, I don't know, how am I really going to be able to pull, you know, these vibrations in? And this is coming from the person who talks to dead people for a living. But, you know, when I was introduced to these years and years ago, I was skeptical and I thought, I don't know. And the very, very first one that I decided to try was the Archangel Michael. And I remember standing in the office space of one of my very, very first offices that I rented. And I thought, okay, Archangel Michael, I invoke your energy now. Come on. And it was incredible, the warmth that I felt from head to toe on my body, feeling my face go flushed, and just feeling this incredible, incredible supported energy. And it made me a believer, and I haven't turned back. And like I said, I utilize him multiple times a day, each and every day. And he's really just an amazing, amazing archangel to work with and to be around. So check out some resources. Check out Doreen Virtue's book, Archangels and Ascended Masters. She's got a couple great oracle decks for Archangels and Ascended Masters. You can, you know, give yourself a little bit of a, you know, challenge yourself for a month, you know, see who you want to work with. Pick one or two people for a week and try to invoke their energy. See what you can change within your life, what can shape and what can move. It is absolutely limitless of what you can do when you set an intention and when you work with spirit. So I'm excited to see what you can get. And if you have any good experiences, give me some feedback. I'd love to hear what you learned or what you were able to connect in with from the other side. Well, it is hard to believe, but our show is just about over. It has flown by today, and I can't wait to connect in with you all next week. We are going to be talking next week about developing and working with your mediumship, and it's going to be a great show. Whether you have any experience whatsoever with mediumship, or whether you've been dabbling in it, this is going to be a show that is going to open your minds. It's going to get you thinking, and it's going to allow you to start really connecting in with those loved ones on the other side. So we're going to have a lot of fun together. So thank you for sharing your time, your energy, and your vibration with me today. And thank you for tuning in to the Kelly Ballard Show, Insight and Inspiration from the Great Beyond on Transformation Talk Radio. You can join me every Thursday at 4 p.m. Eastern, 1 p.m. Pacific. Have a great week. Be open to the awesomeness of the universe. And thank you for allowing me to serve Spirit. Take care, everybody.
You've been listening to The Kelly Ballard Show, Insight and Inspiration from the Great Beyond. Kelly Ballard is a fourth-generation medium and intuitive who covers topics ranging from grief, spirit guides, and listening to your intuition. Kelly can help you get answers and guidance from your loved ones on the other side with a little bit of humor and a lot of healing. Tune in every week and visit www.reflectiveharmony.com to learn more about Kelly and the services she provides. Thanks for listening.